press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss any update from Tech Primers.
In this video, we are going to take a look at a tool called Dive, which is useful for exploring your Docker image and identifying what are the different layers inside the Docker image and what are the different ways in which you can shrink the size of your image or any OCI compliant image for that matter. So Dive is a tool which is developed by a developer called Alex Goodman. You can take a look at his GitHub repository and then see how Dive works. Now let's dive into how to use Dive. Right now I have the version of Dive which is 0.9.1. I'm using this particular version. If you're using Mac, you can do brew install Dive. If you're using Windows, the steps for those instructions are mentioned in the repo here. In order to use Dive, you need to have Docker desktop running in your machine. I have my Docker desktop running here, which is already present. I have different Docker images inside my Docker cache locally, and I want to see my Docker images. I can do a Docker images to see the different Docker image. Recently, I built some image called scaffold. So let's take a look at those images. These images were built by me a few minutes ago. We can leverage Dive to directly use this particular image and its ID to explore what's happening inside that particular image. Now, the moment I do Dive and then give the image ID, which I get from the Docker images, it'll directly use the Docker API to connect to that particular Docker cache, retrieve the image, and then explore that image. This is a slightly heavy image, which is 507 MB, because I'm just using the JDK 8. This is how the Docker file looks like. I use the OpenJDK 8 version. I created a folder called app, and then I copied the jar file onto the app directory with the name springboot.jar. So that is the content of the Docker file. Now let's look at what happened. If we come back, we can see that Dive has explored the image and it is showing us in some graphical form inside the command line. If you see, this is the Docker file or the content layers which are present inside the image. You can see the app directory getting created in the right side. So the left side shows the layers which are present inside the image, and the right side shows the contents of the layer and how they show up after it is done. So for example, I copied the Spring Boot jar into the app folder. You can see that in the right side. The moment I move them in the left side, you can see that in the right side. If I want to move to the next window, I can do a tab and then move my cursor to the right side. That way I can explore what is happening inside my folders, what are the different files which got added as a part of which step and things like that. So this is how you can explore different layers inside the image. Also, Dive provides you other information, like for example, what is the total size of the image and how much efficient can you make this particular image. It shows that the image is already 98% efficient. There is only 9 MB which has got wasted. So using Dive, you can identify if you're creating efficient images. Now, if I want to build a new image, I can use Dive itself. I can do Dive build hyphen T scaffold example colon V3. Let's build a V3 version, and I would like to build it from the current directory. So I can do Dive build hyphen T scaffold example version 3. This will now build the image using the Docker CLI, and it will open as well. Notice that Dive opens the image after it is built, and I can see the same stuff in here. So Dive is basically a CLI. It leverages the Docker commands, the Docker CLI. It plugs into the Docker APIs, and then it can interact with the Docker daemon, which is running in my laptop. I have been using Dive for exploring images. I found it very useful for exploring different layered images. Let's say I'm importing an image from some other third-party repository, and I want to see how efficient that image is, and I want to improve, and I want to see what are the things which are happening inside the image. I definitely use Dive in that particular case. You can take a look at Dive from this particular GitHub link. I'll leave this link in the description below. I hope you found this particular video interesting. As always, if you like the video, go ahead and like it. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and subscribe to it. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you very much.